Dave Kowalski with highlights from the Orange Bowl Stadium in Miami. Wearing the white jerseys, we have the Army with Navy in red. Then we have a first down for the Sailors. Center hikes to Jim Hooper, Navy's all-star quarterback.
Let's go, Army!
Navy 6, Army 0, as Army kicks to Navy. It's a long, high kick almost to the 20-yard line received by number 45, Navy's halfback. And look at him go. He's at the 50-yard line, down to Army's 30, 20. He's going to score, and there it is!
Yes!
Well, Army, nothing. That was an 80-yard run by this boy who was born in Venice, Italy, and who holds the season's league record for...
Place your money on Army. Take it from me. I got inside information. Navy's just a bunch of cripples. You ever get the feeling you're beating a dead horse?
Now it's Army fighting back, and we have a first down on Navy's 10-yard line, and center hikes to Army's quarterback, J.C. Johnson, and he's going to run it. He's across the 10, and it's Navy's fullback, Bruce Davis, who blocks him, and he comes down with less than a yard to go. What a game, ladies and gentlemen. It's another first down for Army on Navy's 1-yard line. Center hikes to number 12, Johnson gives the ball to Donnie Brown, and he fumbles it. After a great season, Army seems to be falling apart. Navy is in complete control of the game. In 20 years of sportscasting, I've never seen such a one-sided contest.
Hey, where's Zeke? Your sister's just hand. You didn't want Navy to win, eh?
Oh, Charlie, it's just that I bet $10 on Army. They told me it was a sure way to raise funds for the orphanage.
Right. You do better to bet on St. Joseph. Gambling never pays, kid.
Is that for real, Charlie? Don't you gamble?
Never. People who gamble lose. Personally, I like to win.
We're at the start of the fifth race on this afternoon's action-packed program. As they roar past the stand, we get a good look at Army Major Danforth Bowles in number 96 of the U.S. Navy. Coming up to the second marker, there seems to be some uncertainty out there. This is no Sunday trip around the bay. Those craft are moving at up to 80 miles per hour. The contest is now all for second and third place. Number 96 is on his way to an easy win. He has the race in his back pocket.
Magnificent. We're going to win again. I wish I could be so sure, sir. What do you mean by that? What did he mean by that, Sullivan? Look, our man's in front out there.
I know he's in front, sir, but he hasn't won yet.
Hey, Mirthless, something ain't working. The wrong guy's winning. Get on it.
Hey, Greaseball. Something ain't working. The wrong guy's winning. You know what's gonna happen if the wrong guy wins.
No, I did everything like you told. Just wait, you'll see.
Hey, no. He's slowing down. 96 is in trouble. He's losing power. We have an upset, folks. Number 96, the favorite, is out of the race. The other boats...
It's a real pity his boat broke down, eh?
Favorite's out of the race.
The leader has destroyed the Navy's chances of an easy win.
Where is he? Where is he? I'll kill him. Come on out. Let's see ya. Hey, have you seen a guy in Norman Rawls with grease on his face?
Why don't you go find a mirror?
Hey, I know you. You're the guy who brought my boat down here, aren't you?
What's it to you?
What's it? Someone's been fooling with the engine!
I couldn't care less.
Is that beans and onions?
No, it's fish and chips.
I like beans and onions. Hey, you want to flip a coin for it? Heads I win, tails we shear it.
I don't gamble. What's more, I don't like guys that try to help themselves to my beans.
Hey, wait a minute. You're the guy I'm looking for. Hey. You're the Turk who messed up my engine, aren't you?
Choice. Your beef is with those guys.
Stand aside, Sambo. You will want to keep your trap shut.
Hey, just a second.
You're on.
Oh, sorry. Hey, hey, come back here.
That clown a friend of yours?
I don't have any friends.
Hey, that smells good. Beans and onions.
I like beans and onions.
Sorry, pal, they're mine. I like peas and onions.
Come back here, you stop! I'm gonna teach you to go messing around with my motor.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Admiral O'Connor wants to speak to you, sir. It's urgent.
Okay, here. Put him in a brig.
Then we'll kill him.
Your personal record is impressive, Lieutenant. Annapolis, graduated cum laude in infinitesimal calculus, winner of last year's California Classic, All-American football, interstate soccer. Now, I don't get this runner-up in the Inter-American middleweight boxing tournament. How come you didn't come in first?
Well, sir, Carlos Monzon was first.
Oh. Oh. Lieutenant, what I'm about to say to you is to be considered top secret. Now, you're probably unaware that organized crime has become a serious threat to the Navy sports program in Florida. Unfortunately, the local police force is, well, not up to our standards. So we've decided to clear decks, Lieutenant, and help out. And our personnel computer has selected you for the job. It'll be risky. Yes. Now, you'll need someone who knows the ropes, and we found just the man to use to our advantage.
I've got a feeling I know him.
Well, we're off to a good start, then.
Well, it sure didn't look that pretty. You mind if I...
Oh, go right ahead, Lieutenant.
Yeah, that's him.
Thanks so much, Charlie. God will reward you. If it was not for you, I'd never be able to get around like this.
That's okay. It's a pleasure, sister. Anything I can do to help you?
You're an angel.
Yeah, I know. Now look, it's none of my business, but even though the orphanage is in financial difficulty...
When you get to the racetrack, don't take a tip from the first town who comes along. Make more selling rosaries.
The Lord moves in mysterious ways.
Yeah, and so do horses. When you get the right odds.
There you go. Oh, wait, Charlie.
Yeah?
How is it you never married?
How about you?
Oh, well, I married Christ.
You mean I should marry the boss?
Oh.
Right, he's not my type. Bye, sister.
Bye. Where's the journey? Bye.
Okay, okay. You're getting hungry, huh? Hit Bob's diner and get something to eat. It's just down the road.
Hiya, Bob.
Hiya, Charlie.
You got any fresh fish?
Yes, we got fish. He's been playing that same ball for the past 45 minutes.
Give me 35 pounds.
35 pounds of fish?
You heard the man. And I bet he wants it raw.
Raw? Is that right, Charlie?
Yeah, I want it raw. I also want a triple hamburger and 3 beers. And that cake with lots of whipped cream.
Funny. I didn't know that.
You didn't know what?
The raw fish goes with beer. I would have chosen a nice chilled white wine. Oh, I'm sorry. Hi. Oops, good catch.
You like onions and peas, don't you?
Yeah, Charlie. Here's your triple hamburger.
Nice, right.
Hey, how about that?
How
I'm up to 8 million points. Yeah. Did you think I deserve a discount on orange juice?
Yeah, sure, why not? 10 cents a glass.
Hey, you want to bet?
I don't gamble, Blue Eyes.
Bob, I'll bet your nickel that I can drink more orange juice than you can squeeze.
That's impossible.
Impossible? Come on, I'll bet your nickel.
Okay. The bet's on.
Enough, Bob. You win. Here. I'm going back to the pinball machine.
See that, Charlie? Anyway, Win, I should have doubled the stakes.
How many oranges you squeeze?
I don't know, about 10, I guess.
Well, for 5 cents, you get a lot of smarts.
You stay here. You two come with me.
Listen, you half-assed little monkey. I've been told you refuse to have one of our slot machines in your joint.
You're darn right. I got a pinball machine. Don't need one.
And pinball machines don't have our seal of approval.
Tell it to them other guys.
All right. Watch my thing. Out of the way, you.
Hey, sorry.
Hey, stop that! Stop, please! You're breaking up my business! How am I gonna explain that?
Where's the machine?
You broke it! How am I gonna explain that?
Oh.
I really wish you hadn't done that. It ain't fair to shove a little guy's face into the cake, especially when the cake is mine.
Shut up.
Talking to me?
Yeah. It's a wise ass.
Stick him up. Or you look like Swiss cheese. You turkeys! He's holding the ball cues on you!
Charlie Ferpo.
Charlie Ferpo? The famous Charlie Ferpo? The number one gambler on the Gulf Coast? Pleased to meet you.
The pleasure's all yours. Bob, give me the fish.
Yeah, Charlie. No, you don't have
to. Come on, take it.
Okay.
Mr. Ferpo, would you mind giving me a lift to Miami? I'm going there, too.
How'd you know I'm going to Miami?
Huh? That's where they have the aquarium with the dolphins, and you're transporting dolphins, so...
How do you know what I'm carrying in my rig?
How do I know? By simple deduction. I figured, no matter how big and ugly you are, you couldn't possibly eat 35 pounds of raw fish.
You're really on the ball, ain't you? How come you don't know I gave up gambling? And I don't give lifts to strangers. Have a nice walk.
Charlie, wanna bet you're gonna give me a lift? I'll put up all I got from the slot machine.
That money's all for Bob. To cover the damage.
You're right.
About your offer. I took the pledge, gave up betting for good. Oh. But this time I'll make an exception.
Yeah?
If you get me to give you a lift, I promise you I'll swallow all 35 pounds of this raw fish.
That's a deal.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye, Blue Eyes. You don't like beans and onions, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
fix up the bag, sister. Hey. Sister, I bet you knew I'd show.
Did you swear you wouldn't bet anymore? Hi there.
Okay, ball breaker. You're gonna get out by yourself or I gotta throw you out.
I'm surprised at you, Charlie Firpo. When a gambler loses, he respects the rules. And I won the bet, didn't I?
You're doing a bet, didn't I?
Hold it! All right. I haven't got the heart. Anyway, it isn't fair to deprive the dolphins of their daily bread. I mean, daily fish. Saying the fish is not fresh. Don't get mad. I'm just interpreter. I really speak their language. Want to see? Hi there. No kidding. She says your driving makes her seasick. Have a nice day.
Listen, Blue Eyes, you can talk to the trees for all I care. What I'd like to know is, why are you sticking in me like I was flypaper?
As my gypsy granny used to say, it's all written in your hand. Let me see. Uh-huh. Born under the sign of Taurus. Irish father and unknown mother. Bachelor. You're very shrewd and resourceful. You've got a kind heart, and you've got a scar on your bottom.
Okay, now you hear this, wise guy. If you were so goddamn smart, then you ought to know you're running one heck of a risk. And you'd quit polluting my environment.
Look, take it easy. I'm not trying to be funny. I'm trying to help you, Charlie Firpo.
Help me, huh?
You bet. Wanna know something?
No.
I'll tell you anyway. I read in the palm of your hand that one of these nights, they're going to steal your truck. When it happens, don't go around saying I didn't warn you.
Now, listen, this is between you and me. Anyone tries to rip up my truck, and they're in for a big surprise. The end of the line. I'm tired. It's my turn to sleep now. I got a long haul tomorrow if I'm going to keep my schedule to Miami.
Hey, what do you say to a round of poker? This joint's got to have a game going.
Get out. You're on my pillow. Get out. Get out.
What am I going to do now? I'm wide awake.
Why don't you read your palm?
Great. Thanks a lot, pal. You'll be sorry.
Beer, please.
Hey there.
Hey yourself.
You're not from around here. You want to play that beer? You like dice?
Actually, I like cards better. Like poker? Only I'm not very good at it.
Well, you're lucky, Rusta.
My name's Johnny.
I'm here with some friends right now. They're playing poker this red-hot minute. Bores the hell out of me. But if you like, I'll introduce.
That's a good idea. Let's go, baby.
Yeah, come to daddy.
Hey, boys, got a friend here who'd like to join in the fun.
I don't know. Not very good, huh?
Yeah, well, none of us is great shakes neither. Have a chair. Join the game. Now, Dippo, Fingers.
Hi.
This is Bugsy, and I'm Nymphus.
And this is Rasta.
She means Johnny.
Thanks, baby. Now go back to the bar.
Okay.
Go ahead, Taylor, ma'am.
See you later, Rasta.
Name's Johnny, huh?
Bring us some sandwiches. Go ahead. I meant cut the deck.
Oh, yeah.
This stairs, okay?
I got it! What do I win?
The prize is you get the deal.
Oh. Sorry. Thank you. Ouch! Sorry.
Not to me, to the right.
Oh, sorry. Thank you.
You gotta ante up first, huh? $10.
I'll do it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Five, right? Thanks.
Yeah, five.
Which is higher, ace or king?
Yeah, the ace.
Thank you.
I'm out.
Four cards.
You won.
Really? Sheesh. My lucky night. I can feel it.
How'd it go?
Huh? Oh, great. I lost $1,283.30.
Yeah, plus the 10,000 you still owe us.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Look, I told you guys. I haven't got it. Would you take an IOU?
Oh, no, you're gonna pay in cash right now. Because if you don't, you're gonna end up like Joe DeMiro. Remember Joe DeMiro in his cement shoes?
Joe DeMiro? Not really. I've always been bad with names.
Jog his memory.
Move your chassis, baby, now.
Hey, now, you guys, take it easy. Listen to me. I've got the truck outside that's worth much more than $10,000. Why don't I pay you up for that?
How do I know you're telling the truth?
Why, sure, I saw a truck outside.
See?
Okay. Now what you're going to do is sign us a transfer of ownership. And don't forget your phone number and the truck's registration.
Sure thing.
Oh, yeah, and make it out in favor of Nymphus Corporation.
Wait a minute, who's this corporation?
Bugsy, you're a jerk.
It's all yours.
Take this and put it away in a safe.
Hey, you're a real crook. Truck's worth twice what he owes.
What do you got, rocks in your head? Mind your own business.
Excuse me, but this beautiful young lady's got a point there. I mean, it's not a four-wheeler. Could you just give me a couple of $100 so I can rent a car?
Okay.
Thank you.
Let's go.
Hey, just a minute. I guess I should warn you, I left a bum sleeping in the cab of the truck. I picked him up along the way. If he should make a fuss, just throw him out.
Don't worry.
Thanks, baby. I'll remember that.
And I'll always remember you, Rough Stuff.
What's wrong with Johnny?
It's an okay name, I guess. Just like Rough Stuff, because I think you're sweet.
I wonder what he's carrying in the trailer.
What's the difference? We only want the truck. Can I drive, boss?
Bugsy, you're a jerk. This thing's worth about 40 grand. Rise and shine, buddy. Let's get out of the truck.
It's okay, officer. All the papers are in order. Brakes, lights, all okay. Good night.
Pull him out.
Hey, you! Out, huh?
Why?
Why? He says why?
Because it now belongs to us and we want to take it home.
Hey, huh?
Because it now belongs to us and we want to take it home, see?
Where? He says where?
It's none of your business. Now step out of there. Move or I'll pull you out by the beard. Getting very impatient. You get the picture?
What's he doing?
First, I'm sleeping and somebody wakes me up abruptly. I always cry. Second, when I cry, I get upset. And when I get upset, then I gotta get up. And when I get up, I get mad. And when I get mad, I gotta get it out of my system.
If it didn't cry, it wouldn't get to you.
Pat!
Oh, I'm sorry, boss.
You're a jerk.
Ow!
Oh!
You're wrong, Charlie Fairpo.
Where are you going? Hey, you can't do that. My ring! My ring!
Easy for you to say. Sure. At least you're covered by insurance. And the Dolphins, too. How am I supposed to work now without my rig? Yeah, I saw it was. The only thing I know is that his name is Johnny. You know, the guy Travolting is called Johnny. There's at least 10 million people in this country called Johnny. Yeah, 10 million people. Give me a beer. Come on, Cappy.
Hello? Yeah. Is there a big guy here named Charlie with a beard who looks mad? Just a minute. Hey, Charlie. It's for you. You want to take it on the phone you just called from?
Yeah, who's speaking?
We have a collect call from Mr. Charlie Fairpo. Are you Mr. Charlie Fairpo, sir?
Yeah.
Will you accept the call, Mr. Fairpo?
Who's calling me?
The party's name is Johnny.
No. Yes. Yes. Give me Johnny.
Right away. Deposit 50 cents, sir.
50 cents. Hello?
Excuse me, sir. 25 cents more, please.
Can't get away with nothing these days. Hello?
Hello? Charlie? This is Johnny. How are you?
I'm going bananas. Where's my truck? Where are you? And how did you know I was here?
You're not carrying a grudge, I hope.
Who, me? No, I'm not mad. I just want to give you a big hug, coochie. Now, please, won't you tell me where you are?
Actually, I'm not far from you, Charlie. But if you want to see me, come to the Hialeah Speedway. You know the record room?
Yeah.
Good, I work there.
You better be there. Now, please, tell me where the rig is. Tell me.
Sorry, sir. You have to deposit $6.25.
Oh, no. $6.
Hello, Charlie. Bye, Charlie. I hope to see you soon. Bye-bye. Bye, Charlie.
Just a minute, please. Operator. Hey, Johnny! Oh, just keep my hands on him.
Hey, the race is about to begin, pal. I'll give you double your money.
How about it, baby?
Yeah, all right.
I'll tell you what. Give me 20 bucks on 43. Just a place, huh?
You got it.
Hey, you need a mechanic? I can fix any kind of car.
We don't fix cars here. We smash them up, bud.
I'm the best wrecker in the business.
Yeah, you want to drive for my team? My best boy broke his leg this morning. I'll give you $50.
Just be sure you don't win.
Come on, I'll show you the car. We've got about 10 minutes.
What's 32 paying?
52.
$50 to win.
143.
No one's betting on you today, so we souped up your machine. You'll be impossible to beat. The boys have spoken to the other drivers. On the track, it'll be like cruising down a freeway. You get one of these when you win, okay?
It's fine with me.
Good.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Lou Sperling giving you a great big welcome from the Hialeah Speedway. We have 2 minutes to start time in today's demolition derby. And these cars are all high-performance machines. Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a great race. The cars are out on the track, just about to complete the promotion lap. And here they come past the stands as they line up on the starting grid with just under 60 seconds to go. Hey, we have a latecomer, number 26, sponsored by Tom's Tires. Well, he just made it in time for the lineup.
Hey, you miserable little runt. Where's my rake?
Look up there, Charlie Frippo. I'm glad to see you.
Darn it, I asked you a question. Where's the dolphins in my rake?
Oh, turn him loose. You know, I feel sorry for him.
Start of the race. First turn, number 26, is making a bid for fifth. He's got it. Sixth place, number 37, right behind 26, who's moving up on third place. Followed by 37. They're bumper to bumper. 26 has the lead. Look out, he's sideways. He's going to lose it. 37 is gaining ground, moving up on the outside. They've left the traffic behind.
Okay, Blue Eyes, where's my rig?
What?
My rig.
What?
I'm warning you, where's my rig, huh? You drove off in it.
Oh, your truck. I lost it to Glenn Bunker. You know how it is. Easy come, easy go, Charlie.
What were you doing gambling with my truck?
I was hoping to win and buy one myself and work with you.
Great idea, Blue Eyes.
37 got the green, 26 is moving away. 26 is staying right with him. You think they were married.
Hey, you no good, tough of bacon fat. Look at that 37. What the hell's going on?
You're the one who told him he should lose.
The 58 is trying to put up a challenge, but he ain't got a snowball chance in hell.
Did 37 get the word?
Hey, I told him, boss, just like you said. The 26 was the win.
If this is a double cross, someone will pay.
That 37 sure is putting up a great show. As we come into turn 26 at the end, he's come up on 37 there. Look, he's there. He's put out. He's going off the track and out of the race. 37 is back in first place. 26, he's pulling back on the track. He's not quitting. They come past the stands with 7 laps to go in this race. Get the 37 out in front. And he's got it all sewed up. There's a lot of action going on back around 10th place. It's the 26, and he's driving his heart out. Moving up through the traffic, passing one car after another. The 33, the 7, moving up on 62. Coming around the south curve, the 43 is out of control. They're all taking the curve too fast. And there goes the 61, followed by the 6. Who's caused the 28? This is now. Four cars off the track, and it's far to go. And there goes the 88 in the second, the 360, and the 6 goes out again. While the 26 just keeps moving up, look at him go. He's fourth, he's third, he's second. He's right on the bumper of 37, and he's taking it at the turn. They're running next and next.
Hey, meet me off the track and I'll kick your ass through a hoop.
I'm ready.
The 37 is taking no slack from the 26 back in first place. How long can they keep up this pace? Wait a minute. Where are they going?
Stop! Stop! What are you...
Let's go get him.
An earthquake!
Hey, that paddock's made you lose. Why are you taking his side?
That fat ox, huh? Called that fat ox happens to be my brother.
Pistachio's melted. Tutti frutti at caramel toffee.
Tutti frutti.
Charlie, how could I tell you right away it was your brother? You might have held it against me. I wanted us to be friends first. You know, you've always blamed me. You always blamed me because our father left your mother to marry mine.
Yeah, nice guy, your father. Like a sailor with a woman in every port.
Hey! How can you say such a thing about our papi?
You know what? I've done some figuring. I only need to sell 137 million of these. Thank you, kid. Before I raise enough for the down payment.
Why wait, Charlie? I mean, a guy like you, a real genius at cards. Huh, you got it made. In 1 month, you can make enough money to buy yourself 10 trucks.
Ron, gambling's for suckers. The house wants you to drop your bundle, it don't matter how good you are. Now, I got an education. When I was dealing in that casino at Pagoras, the Greek, in Havana. Your eyes would have turned green at the crookings. I smashed everything there to little pieces and left.
I heard you broke the Greek's nose, too. Hey. Fix me a cone, will you?
Tutti frutti, caramel toffee,
pistachio.
Vanilla.
Pistachio melted. Vanilla, tutti frutti, caramel toffee, bitter egg, and coffee.
Okay. Then give me a vanilla cone with pistachio.
The pistachio melted. Vanilla, caramel toffee, tutti frutti, bitter egg, and coffee.
Okay, look, just give me a chocolate cone with a little pistachio.
What are you, deaf? The pistachio's melted and I didn't say chocolate.
Wow, don't get so excited. I was just asking. All right, what do you have again?
We have vanilla, tutti frutti, caramel toffee, bitter egg, and coffee.
Oh, I got it. Then give me a big mix, Grandma. Tutti frutti. Caramel toffee, vanilla, bitter egg, and coffee. Hey, don't forget the pistachio.
Salami, guess what I got it for you.
Oh, thanks. I thought you said it melted. I changed my mind now.
What did you say?
I said, I love pistachio.
You put your sweet ass. You know everything about me. See a little about you.
Well,
how come you learn to converse with the fishes?
Well, I've done just about everything. I've been a waiter, salesman, dock worker, shoe repairman, mason, halfback. I've even been
a truck thief. Yeah, I know. Jack of all trades, master.
I had to do it. I had to do it for Poppy. You walked out on him. Who do you think took care of him, huh?
Don't speak to me about him. He made life miserable for me and Mama. Lousy bum, couldn't even get a job. 10 years ago, I worked out on him. So help me, one of these days he crosses my path again, I'll show him.
Save your breath. You won't be able to show him anything no more.
Why?
Because...
Get my way.
Because Poppy's blind now. I sold it to pay for an eye operation for him. That's why I stole it, Charlie. But then I lost all the money gambling. I must have been taken by every shark from Mexico to Florida. Hey, there he is.
tempo muta da tempo.
Where did he learn those words from, your mother?
Believe me, I've always done my best to give him enough to live on. But he wants to sing. It makes him feel he's on his own. He's hard-headed. He thinks he has a nice voice.
Poppy! Poppy!
Who's that, my voice?
Poppy!
My voice!
Oh.
My voice!
Hi, Poppy!
Charlie!
I brought you Charlie! It's me and Charlie!
My voice! My voice! Where are you, Charlie? Charlie, oh, Charlie, you feel more like your mother every day.
Charlie, over here.
Charlie, my boy.
Charlie's right, Poppy. You'll be happy here. Everything is so beautiful. I only wish you could see it.
Sister Suzanne will take good care of you here. Johnny and me will find a way to raise the money for your eye operation. Don't you worry.
Thanks, Charlie. You see what those bastards done to me?
Charlie, that's when he went blind, after they beat him up.
And only because I'm your father.
I'll give you back your sight, Poppy. It was the last thing I ever do. What's this operation cost?
Not much. $100,000.
$100,000? Is that including green stamps?
It's a very difficult operation. Besides, Poppy wants blue eyes. And you know, blue eyes cost more.
Hey, Poppy, how about some other color? You see just as good, eh?
It's that or nothing.
Like father, like son. The prettiest nuns is Jennifer Jones.
And for whom the bell tolls?
No, that was Gary Cooper. Yes.
I thought you'd like some tea. Let me pour you a cup, Mr. Furfo.
No. I want to serve myself. I'm self-sufficient.
You certainly are, Poppy. Yeah, let me help you. This is the teapot.
This is the cup, Poppy.
There, yeah, there you go.
Oh, the cup nice and
steady. Is it good and hot, Sister Suzanne?
Yeah, pour it away.
It's hot.
It is?
Okay.
Poppy.
What?
The cup's there.
There you go.
That's fine.
Enough.
Lemon.
Poppy. Let me do it.
Yeah, that's... Poppy, please. I think it's better if somebody else squeezes your lemon.
Don't Poppy. That's all right.
Poppy will be spilling it all
over. I do hope your father can stay here until the operation. Because, as I told you, in about a month we will have to move from here.
We're going to raise $100,000. That ain't easy in the best of times.
We'll make it, Charlie. Because we'll do it together. Like brothers. Poppy, Charlie will teach me to become as great a gambler as he is. We'll go to all the legal gambling spots in town. Mm-hmm. And if that isn't enough to make the $100,000 we need, Charlie can always introduce me to Paragolis the Greek.
Oh.
He's the one who roughed up Poppy, you know. He knows where he hangs out, don't you?
I know where he is, but you don't know Paragolis the Greek. He's too much for you to handle. He's dangerous.
Nothing is too dangerous for the Firpo brothers.
And Poppy's worth it, right?
Okay. So, we win enough for the operation. And a new truck for me. And after that, we quit, all right?
Right, good.
Poppy, those Firpo brothers.
Right.
Bye-bye. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
I'm happy to be able to return a favor after all you've done for me. We'll take good care of him. Come on, Mr. Firpo. I'll show you to your room.
Thanks.
This way.
But I can get out of here. Sometimes, can I?
That?
I mean, thanks. Quite often?
Of course you can, Mr. Firpo. This is not a prison.
That is exactly what I wanted to hear. and sister,
yes?
Could I please have a television set in my room,
of course,
please?
You can. What did you say? A television?
Oh, yes. I love to listen to the dog races on TV.
Now, here's what we do. Six race, we bet $100 on a favorite.
Well, shouldn't we pick a horse that gives better odds?
Nah, the race is fixed. If you want to learn, don't ask questions. Keep your eyes open and your mouth shut. You see the guy in a check jacket? That's what's called a bookie. The racetracks that come out of the woodwork, and they all work for the syndicate. Now I will approach one of them and put the 100 on the favorite. Then we make sure that the favorite wins. You wait here.
Hiya, Charlie. It's good to see you again. Can I buy you a drink?
I'm going to show my friend that betting with you is better than at the window. Good. How you're going to take $100 on Lightning Rod, number 7. And instead of 2-1, I'll take 11-1.
11-1?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, but what should I do with these tickets?
Why don't you eat them?
Eat them?
Yeah.
A beer.
Hey there.
Hey yourself.
What are you doing here? Betting on the Nags?
Only on the ones that win.
I got a sure tip for you. There's a killing to be made on the 6th race.
Lightning Rod.
No, Lightning Rod's a favorite, but he won't win. Bet on Cookie. He'll come in first. It's all taken care of. They had a word with the jockeys, if you understand.
Thank you.
Catch you later.
Yeah, you bet.
Just like you said, they're clamoring to put money on Lightning Rod. Over 50 grand so far.
What'd you expect? He's the favorite.
You bet he's the favorite. And a nag had better not win. Well, we'll be up the creek.
Don't worry, the driver knows the life of his little baby's at stake. He'd break the horse's legs first.
Why don't we go now?
What do you mean, go?
Hurry. If we hurry, we'll just have time to throw ourselves under the Miami-New Orleans Express. The tracks are about 50 yards from here.
Is it? You think that's funny? Come on.
Do you think it's funny that we're gonna lose all the cash we have to our name? My fairy godmother just gave me a hot tip. Lightning Rod is not gonna win.
Huh? Well, you wait and see who's gonna win.
Hello? Who? Who do you want? Lightning Rod's driver. Hold on a second. Hey, you Lightning Rod's driver?
Yeah, why?
You wanted on the telephone.
Jeez, I hope nothing's happened to the kid. Hello? Who's calling? Hello? Hello?
Hey, just what? Sit back and leave the driving to us.
Hey, that doesn't look like Lightning Rod's usual driver.
Sure it's him. What do you think it is?
Hey, what you smiling at?
I'll smile at whatever the hell I want to.
They're lining up behind the starting car, folks, for this evening's 6th race. Look at those drivers. They're all in there jockeying for the best...
Hey, buddy, you're not Sam Stallion.
Of course I'm Sam Stallion. Don't you recognize me?
I'm not that stupid. You're not Sam.
Why don't you call me and see if I answer you?
Hey, Sam, hi.
Oh, hi. See?
25, 10, and they're off and running. The favorite Lightning Rod is on the inside. Number 6, high-end Pepper Penny across the track, taking lead. Followed by number 2, Julian, Ben Middle Indian, Lightning Rod, Houdini, and Fast Frank. Lightning Rod seems to have gotten himself boxed in. High-end Pepper is still out in front, followed by Julian, Middle Indian, and Fast Frank. This is a run change. They go into the first turn. Julian is challenging Cayenne Pepper. There's quite a tussle going on out there. In the back stretch is still anybody's race. But now it's Lightning Rod who's making his move. He's gaining ground, moving up on the inside. Cayenne Pepper has broken stride. Lightning Rod is alongside Julian, who's taking the lead.
Come on.
Shut up.
Come on.
Hey,
you shut
what's
up.
That fool up to?
Hey, hold him back, Sam.
I can't help it. He's going too fast. Hey, you're going too fast.
Vivian is fighting back, but it's Lightning Rod. He's showing
the horse. Track, and now it's I took a bet on that horse 11-1 odds.
11-1, you jerk, Bugsy.
What are you picking on me for? It was you said Lightning Rod was going to get beat.
But, Hook!
Long stretch, it's still Lightning Rod with Vivian fighting all the way. But Lightning Rod isn't taking any chances. And as they pass the post, we have...
Hey!
Rod, Vivian second, Bass Frank third, then Coco and Houdini.
Two of you go to the house of that dumb bastard, Sam Stallion. You know what to do. And if he ain't there, then give it to his baby. Understand?
Let's go, George.
Now, what were the odds you said you gave on Lightning Rod?
11-1.
11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You heard what the boss said about it. He's not there. And a boss's orders are the boss's orders.
You go up and get the baby. Hey, George, there's something here that ain't quite kosher.
Now, stop being a turkey. Throw the kid out the window and let's get out of here.
You ever picked up a kid before?
Ready.
Coochie, coochie, coo.
Hey, George, doesn't that kid look like someone we know?
Now, all babies look alike.
Next time, pick a kid your own size. Got that? After a royal flush, comes four of a kind. Not a full house, three of a kind, two pair, and a pair. You remember where the ordinary flush is straight, go, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's that?
Wait a minute. Four of a kind. Hey, that's a pretty good hand.
I have more ways than one.
What else, master?
And then you got the LF.
I never heard of that.
The luck factor. When Lady Luck decides you're high on her list and you ain't a bad player, nobody can beat you.
Let me see now. In American poker, using all 52 cards with no jokers, you've got 1.75 probabilities in a million coming up with a royal flush. 3.75 for a kind, 11.9 for a straight, 64 for a full house, 186 for three of a kind, 275 for a pair, but none of it is of any use unless you've got the LF. How's that, Mr. Firpo?
Arithmetic ain't my strong point.
You're right.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, today's
yeah.
My lucky day. Would you pass me that? Let's see your money, boys. Here's two tennis. Baby, come to daddy.
You want to do it? Yeah, no.
Hey, Mike Firpo. You seem pretty happy.
You see that? I won.
Yeah, but you're playing in our territory.
Yeah. Go on.
Hey, that fine stuff won't work with me. Now, we told you to keep out of here.
Well, yeah. Oh, my God. What the hell? Get him! Watch out.
I'll raise you two bananas.
Hey. That's Poppy.
Oh, come on. That's impossible.
Well, take a look. There he goes.
There he goes.
I think you're nuts, Charlie.
I don't see him, but I know I saw him.
Come on, Charlie. I still got a lot to learn.
Gosh darn it, I tell you, I'm sure I saw him.
Let's go back upstairs, huh?
Come here, come here! Now, who were you running after?
Who, us?
Yeah, you were running after our Poppy.
Come on, knock it off. You know our father's blind.
Don't go telling me the old goose.
Whatever you're doing, it'll teach you not to do it, huh? Right, Charlie? You'll be ashamed of yourself.
Listen, Blue Eyes, if you and Poppy are putting me on, I'll smash your face.
Go on. Why don't you say what you really mean? That you don't believe your own flesh and blood, your own father gave you your most precious gift, your existence. And you don't even believe me. Your own brother was trying to help you find a purpose. Your aimless, empty, and wasted life. See, you even made me catch a cold. Are you happy now?
Right.
That's okay. Let's just keep our minds on how we can make the money we need. Come on, Charlie. I know there's so much more you can teach me. Let's go back upstairs and start all over again, okay?
You sweated blood to put this little state together. Now we're gonna use it. You take it and bet it all on the guy I told you to.
Sure thing, Charlie.
I see it.
Okay, let's go.
Hey, where's the famous highlight world champion? Hamid Serrano.
Charlie, fearful.
Hey, amigo.
Hola, amigo mio.
Yeah, caught you with your girdle off.
Don't make fun of me. I'm not what I once was when you and I played together. Look what I have to do to look younger.
Yeah, you look terrific.
I know. To tell the truth, I can hardly follow the ball anymore. It's kind of embarrassing. But it's not all my fault. Had plovitis in the leg here. Touch of arthritis.
Arthritis, huh? Yeah, tell me the good news about these.
I think tonight will be my last match. They hire me because I'm a clown. About the time has come to give it up. No more pelota. Getting too old.
Don't give me that. Tomorrow all the papers will be talking about you just like in the good old days.
How I wish. But the bookies are giving 10-1 odds. You know what that means.
Well, would you believe my brother's betting $50,000 on you?
$50,000? Your brother's local. You better get him to the nut house right away.
Yeah, I know. He's been that way for years. I'm the guy that gotta watch.
Would you please make an offering for the orphans? Thank you very much. Will you give an offering, please? Will you make a donation, please?
Hey.
All right, I'm coming.
Go inside.
Hey there. Want a candy?
Hey, Rasta. I'm really glad to see you again.
I'm glad to see you, too. By the way, thanks for the tip you gave me at the racetrack, remember?
I do the same for all my friends.
Hey, those guys over there are your friends, huh?
Not in the sense you mean. I belong to me. You'd be the only one I could really go for.
Oh, really? I'll remember that. What are the odds on Ramon Serrano?
10-1.
Well, I'm gonna put the whole wad on him. $50,000.
Are you crazy? Ramon Serrano's finished. He's run down. Nobody bets on him. Nymphus and the gang are giving those odds because they know he won't win.
Well, I like risks. Hey, remember me?
Hey, want to place a bet?
Yes, sir.
One minute to game time. Take your seats, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we're coming up to the last match and this evening's main event. The players are on the court. And in post one, we have number 24, Arrhenia the Cheese. Post two, number 32, Mendez Killer Jose. Post four, number 50, Ruiz El Topo. Post five, number 42, Salazar. Post six, number 45, Primero. Post seven, Gonzalez. And at Post 3, Jamón Jamón Serrano, just as colorful as always. Post 8, number 54, Luis Del Rey. There you are, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start the match. The first encounter is between Arriña in red and Mendez in light blue. In this particular contest, the individual player gains points by outplaying and eliminating his opponent. And the first match has begun. The player must throw the ball or pelota in such a way that his opponent cannot return it. And there you have it. Arriña is the loser. Now, Mendez must face Jamón Jamón Serrano in the white jersey. Veteran Serrano eliminates Mendez in spite of his courageous attempt to recover the ball. Now out in the court comes Ruiz El Topo. As you may know, the ball can bounce off the end and side walls, but can only bounce once on the floor before it must be returned by the opposing player. Fine volley, Ruiz fails to return the ball. Number 3 wins again. He now has 2 points, and it's one-time world champion Calendaro's turn. He gets the ball off the wall and returns it at high speed, but Serrano curls it back into play. Salazar goes up on the wall again, but loses his balance. He's outlasted tonight. Serrano now has won 3 games and faces Carlos Primer. Goes up, but can't reach high enough. And Jamón Serrano wins his 4th straight game. Now it's Gonzalez's turn to try and stop this amazing winning streak. Absolutely incredible. Serrano continues to win and now has 5 points. He must now face Luis Del Rey. Sensational! Jamón Serrano, the ham bone, has proved he can still win. He's done it. He's won the match. He is the new champion. Let's hear that.
Bravo!
Ladies and gentlemen. This veteran champion was inclined, but tonight he has come back to beat some of the world's best players.
So Serrano ain't worth a dime. What with his phlebitis, his beer drinking, his slip disc. But you, Bugsy, you're a jerk, a numbskull. You got a pea brain, Bugsy. That little wager's gonna cost us $500,000. And who's gonna break the news to the Greek?
I will. Just take me to his place, and I'll be glad to tell him. I'll put up $500,000 you owe me for this match in a poker game. But I only want to play with him. For a good is the Greek, huh?
Hey, listen, boys. You know, this guy's a real nerd at cards. You remember when we played with him before? He lost his shit. Believe me, against the Greek, he won't even have a chance of winning.
He's right, you know. The boss will take him to the cleaners and he'll lose it all anyway.
It's a deal. Consider yourself invited to the Greeks for a friendly little family game, all right?
Would you mind giving me the money first?
Pay him.
$100,000, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000, $500,000.
Everything is going as planned. Lieutenant Firpo is close to pinpointing the location of the Greek, the man we've been after, thanks to the help he's had from his father, Mike Firpo.
Admiral, as you requested, we've arranged to have the police drop the charges against Firpo's father.
They were after him for everything from bouncing bad checks to raising mayhem.
Raising mayhem? I thought you got a medal for that.
Admiral O'Connor.
Hello? I'm calling for Johnny Firpo. He said to tell you that he's on his way to the place he has been looking for, and that you should follow him as you had arranged to. No, that's all he said. You're welcome.
Hiya, sister.
Oh, hello, Charlie.
You see my brother around here?
Oh, yes. He said to say hello to you. You won a lot of money. He gave me an offering of $1,000.
Hey, what are you doing? Put the... Anything else?
Oh, yes. He also said to give you this note.
How are you, Charlie? I'm going to put up all the money we won in a poker game. Since you're my master, I better be the pants off the Greek. You and Pappy and Sister Suzanne and the orphans too, huh? Please root for me. Thanks. Yours forever. Your brother. P.S. Don't get mad, huh?
Good news?
Very bad news. He's alive.
Oh!
This way. We're taking a boat ride.
Where are we going?
Didn't you tell me you wanted to play with paragulas? Well, let's go.
Water. You jump in to save me, we'll swim back to shore, and then you beat it.
What do we have to do all that for?
Because I don't want you ruined. I saw how you play. Like a baby. Paragulas is the biggest card shark around. Listen to me, rough stuff. Just keep your money and beat it.
Your plan wouldn't work, baby. But I like the part about the mouth-to-mouth resuscitation to save your life.
Well, if it's only for that.
Hey, what are those two doing?
Bugsy, you know what you are?
Yeah, I'm a jerk.
Looks like we got a big bird in the sky for an escort.
Navy Command, Navy Command. This is Condor 8020. Calling Navy Command. Admiral, the launch is going outside territorial waters. So it's impossible to pursue any further.
Damn it. Now we can't intervene. The launch has gone outside territorial waters.
That means Lieutenant Firpo will find himself alone and without help in the hands of the underworld somewhere at sea.
Our whole plan will fail.
You listen to me, friend. Never trust people who got blue eyes. Never. Especially if they brother.
Give him the line.
Got here.
Nice place, huh? After you.
Hey,
And we have a 24, black, even. Sorry about that, ma'am. I'd like to play just black this time.
Okay. Let's see that for a minute, please.
There you are, sir.
Two was the last number, right?
Yes, two was the last number.
Right.
Maybe
I'll
have
a third.
Place your bets.
111,
please.
One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. Okay. $10,000 on the night. Plain, chevaux, carret, triplet, and dust. $3,000 on the column, pass, pair, and $2,000 on red.
Oh, watch this guy. It's something. No more bets, please. Here we go.
Not bad, eh? I'm a wizard in infinitesimal calculus. I just worked out the probabilities.
Thanks, ma'am.
What number should I play now? Please advise me.
Well, you have to wait for your mathematical probability to come around again. And with this wheel, it'll be 19,822 turns.
What do you mean I have to wait that long?
You just have to be patient.
Is this the creep who won all that money which you guys owe to me?
Yeah, that's him. He's trying to bankrupt us. He won $500,000 at Pelota, and now $154,000 in one go at roulette.
And board my boat. No one is allowed to get away with that. Some way he must be made to understand that winning will be very bad for his health.
I've been doing some thinking, boss. You know, that guy is real lucky when it comes to picking winners. But when it comes to playing poker, he's a babe in arms. While you are the sharpest in the whole world.
And in outer space.
In the whole universe, boss.
Okay, we clip his wings at poker. Call him.
Nice try. I had a truck once, too. Nice truck. But my brother stole it. My brother stole my truck.
Your brother took your truck?
Yeah.
You're lucky. My brother took my wife.
I'm glad to make your acquaintance, Johnny Fairpool. That is your name, isn't it? A name is not completely new to me.
Not as new as that nose of yours that my brother Charlie rearranged for you.
So you're Charlie Firpo's brother.
You bet. He's strong with cards and tough with his fists.
But they tell me you're better at cards. That right?
Well, I have learned to play the game, Mr. Pargulis.
Well, now we'll see. Cut. A grand.
A full pot makes me hot.
I hate smart remarks when I play poker. They make me very nervous.
Me too.
I'm in.
How many?
The pot's still light.
Three cards.
The same.
One. Take three.
Anybody want a bite? An apple a day gets a doctor away.
It's a cinch. I can do it with my eyes closed. See that? Now, I will show you Firpo's most famous shot, known as the Firpo Double Whammy, which succeeds only one time in 100. And I'm going to do it backwards.
Charlie, I can see you. Charlie, I can see you. Yes, it's a miracle. It's a miracle, Charlie.
A miracle. A miracle!
Hey,
Go find Blue Eyes.
Straight.
Shh.
I'd sure like to know how the hell you manage to win all the time.
I got a whole orphanage praying for me.
Ten.
No shame in a friendly game.
Just stop with the wisecracks. They're not funny and we're not amused.
Me neither. Me neither.
How many cards?
Four.
Three.
Two.
And a dealer takes three.
$2,000.
I'll raise your double.
I'm out. Double again.
All right. I'll see you.
Full house.
Good hand. Excuse me. I've got a 5, a 6, a 7, an 8, and a 9. All hearts. I guess that beats a full house, huh? Right?
I don't believe it. You took 4 cards. How did you do it?
Don't ask me. Ask the orphans.
Let's play again.
Okay. Cut. Well, what are we going to play for?
I put up the boat, the casino, and everything that goes with it.
But first, you'll have to excuse me for a double P.
What's that?
A double P. P-P.
Oh, God.
I'll be back in a flash. Excuse me. Would you hold this, please? Thank you. There you go. You know, it's not that I don't trust you folks. I always do this. Thank you. Oh. Hey, where is everybody?
Sleeping.
Already?
Yeah.
Hey, hello.
Thank you. You gonna wait for me?
Wouldn't want you to get lost.
Did you want to come in?
Yeah.
Sorry. Hey, what's going on? Aren't you guys going to play?
No, Johnny Firpo.
Huh, why not?
Because now it's just between us two. One to one, face to face. And we're going to play five card stud, all right?
Sure, that's fine with me.
Get out.
Good luck, huh?
Thanks, baby. Should we put a value on this old tub?
This old tub cost me more than $1 million.
You got ripped off.
I've always had a pretty good nose for a deal.
Maybe, before you met my brother. Let's say it's worth $500,000.
The tub on the first card. You won't have much left for the others.
Hey! When I give you the signal, cut me loose!
All right, my boy, but be careful!
Your pants.
What?
Your pants.
You're bluffing. You can't be serious. You gotta be bluffing.
If you wanna see, you gotta pay. And you're short $3,000. And $3,000 for a pair of pants is not a bad deal. What else have you got?
The upper hand. Ho, ho, ho.
Let me see. That's not enough. This isn't worth more than $300. Come on, come on. Your pants.
What are you guys waiting for? Throw it to the shark.
Hey, hold it. Take it easy, guys. Let's not get uptight about a little game between friends. I tell you what, Mr. Paragoulis. What if we do it this way? You take me to shore on this nice, beautiful boat, and you can have it all back. It's all yours. Here. It's all yours, Mr. Paragoulis.
First, I want to see if you are bluffing. Push the Joker in the water.
Geronimo!
Hey, look who's here.
Johnny Firpo.
Shut up.
Peace.
What a nice surprise. Did you come to gamble, huh?
Come to get a pair of blue eyes for our puppy.
Now, take it easy, Charlie. Calm down. I know when you're nervous, it's hard for you to understand. But let me explain. I can explain everything. Charlie, remember when we were kids? United we'd stand and divided we'd fall? And remember how together we used to beat everybody, right? Huh?
I'm sorry. Don't worry,
now
you gotta get it.
Oh, gosh, I'm sorry. Don't get mad.
Oh, not again.
Poor guy.
This is not my day.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah?
Are you fighting yourselves or against us?
You didn't get it yet?
No.
I'll explain it to you.
Good.
Thank you.
to your lucky night.
One for you, one for you.
Hey, you both lost.
Hey!
My hand slipped. Clean? Don't worry, I'm not gonna use this.
No.
Look. Let's see. Like working together, huh?
Yeah, behind you.
Hey. Watch out!
You'd think they'd have learned, wouldn't you?
Why don't you hit him? That one? Let's clean them all up. Okay. I'll fill now. Nice going. Hey, Nymphus, come
here.
Yeah,
sure, sure.
Now the joker's on the table. Oops, will you look at that? We forgot one. Hold on, friend. Help is on its way.
You'll never get the boat to land.
Who says? He's right. We gotta find a way to get this tub back to land.
Huh. No, we don't.
Okay, man. Get them on their feet and get them out of here.
Hey, how'd you do that?
Simple.
Actually, it was them. I only told them what to do.
Guys talking about?
Why don't you learn how to speak Dauphinese? It comes in handy in occasions like this. I also speak Turtleese, Crocodilese, Hippopotamese.
Hey,
oh, hey.
Hi.
Hey, yourself.
Here's a souvenir.
Thanks.
Come see me in the clink.
I don't have to do that. I'll pay your bail and take
Come
you out to dinner tonight.
Can talk later.
What'd you say,
I couldn't
huh?
ask for anything better. Johnny.
See you later.
My boys.
Johnny. Charlie, I'm proud of you. Admiral, I hope you keep your promise.
Admirals always keep their promises. And I want to make one thing clear. This mission would not have been successful without the help of your son, Charlie Firpo, to whom the United States Navy wishes to offer a brand new truck. And it's got the works. CB radio, automatic shift, radio tires, you name it. As for your other son, there'll be a decoration. Congratulations, Lieutenant Firpo.
What's this, Lieutenant Firpo? You putting me on?
No, not this time, Charlie. Admiral, I'd like to make a last bet with my brother, sir.
A bet? Gentlemen, what do you say we look over this ship?
Okay. Let's make the bet of a lifetime. We got a cool $1 million between us, all from gambling. What do you say we flip for it? Heads or tails?
But boys, what about me? What about me? What about your poor old father who loves you so?
Don't worry, Poppy.
What?
I'll decide how we do this. Heads, it's all for you, okay?
Uh-huh.
Tails, it's half a Poppy, half for me. There's neither heads or tails. It all goes to Sister Suzanne and the orphanage.
Deal.
Poppy, you flip it.
Like you used to do on the beach when we were kids.
Okay, boys.
You see that? Neither heads nor tails. It all goes for the orphanage.
How did you do that?
You know who that was? Jonathan Livingston Firpo.
I realize